In the 2010s, we witnessed some of the greatest goalies in recent history, with Carey Price and Henrik Lundqvist standing out as top contenders. Today, we'll compare their careers by ranking different stats and categories out of 10 to determine who was the better goaltender. Let's dive in and settle the debate between Carey Price and Henrik Lundqvist. We'll start off with the basic stats with career save percentage. The league average save percentage throughout the career of Carey Price was .908, according to StatMuse. During his 712-game NHL career, Price put up a save percentage of .917, which is a significant increase from the league average. This means that I will give Carey Price a 9 out of 10 rating for career save percentage. The league average save percentage during Lundqvist's career was the exact same at .908. However, Lundqvist ever so slightly beats out Price in career save percentage with a percentage of .918. This isn't nearly enough more to get a higher rating, so they both sit at a rating of 9 out of 10. Next, we'll move on to the other basic goalie stat, goals against average. During the career of Carey Price, the league average for goals against average was 2.67, according to Hockey Reference, which means that the average NHL goaltender was letting in 2.67 goals a game. While Carey Price was obviously above average or below average, depending on how you look at it, with a career goals against average of 2.51. He also has the 15th lowest goals against average of all goalies since his 2009-2010 season. With his goals against average, I'll give him a solid rating of 8 out of 10. Lundqvist once again edges out Price in this stat. Lundqvist boasts a very impressive career goals against average of 2.43 compared to the league average during his career of 2.68. Lundqvist has the 17th lowest goals against average since the 2009-2010 season, but still has a better career goals against average than Price. With this, I'm giving Lundqvist a 9 out of 10 rating for goals against average. Now moving on to goals saved above expected, or GSAX, which is definitely a more advanced stat. If you don't already know what goals saved above expected is, go check out my short which explains it, which should be available to click on the corner of this video. Anyway, on average in his career, Carey Price had a goal saved above expected of 2.97. He was really inconsistent though throughout his career, with having a league's best 33.2 in 2015, but also a league's worst in 2018 of -29.4. Even through this inconsistency, Price holds the highest goal saved above expected in the entire league from 2007 to 2022, and is not even really close. He had a GSAX of 118.4 compared to the second place of 106.8. Despite his inconsistency, overall he had the highest goal saved above expected by far of his era, so I'm going to give him a 9.5 out of 10. If he wasn't so inconsistent, I would give him 10 out of 10. During his amazing NHL career, Lundqvist had an average goal saved above expected of 7.11, which is amazing, especially since he definitely fell off in terms of goals saved above expected in the later stages of his career, as he went into the negatives for the last four seasons of his career. Although he had a much higher average yearly goal saved above expected, in the grand scheme of things, he ranked far behind Price at 6th highest goal saved above expected from 2007 to 2022 with 90.7, which, don't get me wrong, is still incredible. With all this being said, I'm giving Lundqvist a very solid 8.5 out of 10, but I'm pretty close to giving him a 9. Moving away from the stats now, we'll move on to awards. Unfortunately, neither of these goalies ever won the Stanley Cup. However, they both got very close and both lost in the finals in 5 games. Carey Price still has a very impressive trophy case, as he won a record-breaking 4 individual trophies in a single season back in 2015. All in 1 year, Price won the Hart Trophy for League MVP, the Ted Lindsay for League's Best Player, the Vezina for League's Best Goalie, and the William M. Jennings for being part of the tandem who let in the least amount of goals. Other than that, he only won one other award in his career, which was the Bill Masterton, for showing dedication to the game when he came back from injury and some other issues in 2022. With all these awards and the record-breaking 2015 season, I'm giving Carey Price a 9 out of 10 for awards. Henrik Lundqvist only won one trophy in his career with the Vezina back in 2012, but he has come very close in other few times, coming second in voting in 2013 and landing in the top 5 numerous times. With all this being said, and only one trophy win, unfortunately the highest I can give him is 7.5 out of 10. So it's clear they both had lots of success in the NHL, but how about the international stage? While throughout his career, Carey Price won many medals, which are a World Juniors Gold, an Olympics Gold, a World Cup Gold, and a U18 Silver. He also took home multiple individual awards from these tournaments as well. He won the Olympics Best Goaltender, U20 Best Goalie, and the MVP, as well as being a World Junior All-Star. The 2014 Olympics would bring the best goaltending we've ever seen out of Carey Price. He would play 5 games in the tournament, winning all 5 and having an amazing save percentage of .972 and a goals against average of .059. The entire tournament, he would only let in 3 goals during the 5 games, which is unheard of and arguably the greatest ice hockey Olympics performance of all time. With all this on his international resume, I have to give him a 9.5 out of 10. Lundqvist was great on the international stage as well, winning an Olympic gold, a World Championship gold, 2 World Championship silvers, an Olympic silver, and a U18 bronze. He was also awarded with being an All-Star for the Olympics and the World Juniors. His best international tournament would have to be the 2017 World Championships, when he went 4-0 with the tournament's best save percentage of .946, the goals against average of 1.31, which is incredible. These achievements are amazing, and I'll give him a very solid 9 out of 10 for internationals. The next category is one of the most important, the primes of their career. Their prime is how these goalies are remembered, and it's the height of their careers. Carey Price had one of the best goalie primes during his 3-year stretch from 2014 to 2016, having a record of 88-38. His 2015 season is one of the greatest goalie seasons of all time, with a save percentage of .933 and a goals against average of 1.96. He also recorded 6 shutouts, which helped him win all those awards, which I mentioned earlier. During his prime, he carried the Canadiens all the way to the conference finals, where he'd unfortunately injure his knee, which pretty much ruined his chances of ever getting a ring, but if he stayed healthy, it would be a much different story. His prime also included the legendary 2014 Olympics run, which we just talked about. Overall, Price had one of the greatest goalie primes of all time, which is why I'm giving him a perfect 10 out of 10 for prime. Lundqvist also had an amazing prime, going 99-61 during his stretch from 2011 to 2013. In 2012, Lundqvist held a save percentage of .930, and goals against average of under 2, which is always impressive, with 1.97. This performance would win him his first and only career Vezina trophy. In 2014, Lundqvist would go on to bring the Rangers all the way to the Cup Finals, just unfortunately coming up short. Overall, Lundqvist had an outstanding prime, which will be remembered for years to come, so he earns himself a 9 out of 10. Next up, we'll be taking a look at their consistency during their career, and this is where Price definitely falls off. Although he was amazing during his prime, he was very consistent during his career. For example, he led the NHL in goals saved above expected in 2015, but was dead last just 3 years later in 2018. Price went from a .923 save percentage in 2017, then down to a .900 in 2018, then back up to a .918 in 2019. It wasn't just season to season either. Sometimes he would be game to game inconsistency. He just wasn't consistent during the later parts of his career, so I have to give him a weak 6 out of 10 for consistency. On the other side though, Lundqvist was a pretty consistent goalie in the NHL. He always held a season save percentage of .905 or higher and never had a significant decrease in save percentage from season to season. He was in the positives and goals saved above expected every season up until 2017, and generally in his career, his goals saved above expected was around 10, which is very good throughout a career. Overall, I'm going to give Lundqvist a 9 out of 10. Last but not least, we'll take a look at their overall impact on their teams. Carey Price had a massive impact on the Montreal Canadiens and was pretty much the only reason why they were good in the mid-2010s. Price only played with one player who scored over 80 points in a season, which was Kovalev in his rookie year. As a comparison, when Colorado won the Cup in 2022, they had 4 players who scored 80 points or more in that season alone. Even through this horrible offense and scoring ability that he had to play with, the Canadiens were still near the top of goal differential during the mid-2010s, and it's all thanks to him. We saw just how important he was to the team during the 2014 playoff run. With him in nets, they swept the Lightning in the first round, then upset the best team in the league, the Boston Bruins, in 7, but after Price got injured in Game 1 of the Conference Finals, the team fell apart and lost the series in 6 games. Also in 2021, he led the Montreal Canadiens to another amazing playoff run, when he completely carried a pretty mediocre Habs team all the way to the Stanley Cup Finals. Everybody knows the only reason the Habs made it past even the first round was because of the elite goaltending they had in Price. Overall, Carey Price was the sole reason the Canadiens were even remotely good during the 2010s, so I have to give him a 10 out of 10. Lundqvist also had a huge impact on his team, the New York Rangers. At his best, the Rangers became a top team in the NHL. In 2012, Lundqvist had a similar problem to what Price faced, in that he didn't have a team that was great at scoring goals and producing offense, and the top point scorer for the Rangers that year was Marian Gaborik, who scored 76 points. Even through that struggle, he allowed the Rangers to finish the season second in the league and first in the Eastern Conference. During the Rangers' Cup Finals run in 2014, he was by far the best player on the team, having a save percentage of .927, the goaltending average of 2.14, and his team simply failed him in the finals. Overall, throughout his career, he was always the best player on the team and made the Rangers a competitive team when sometimes the team around him wasn't the best. For overall impact, I'm giving Lundqvist a 9.5 out of 10. So, after taking a look at all these categories and tallying up the points, Carey Price finishes with a score of 71 total points, and Lundqvist earns a total of 70.5, which means that Carey Price just barely beats out Lundqvist in this comparison. But I'm going to be honest, it could definitely go either way, and there's no real right or wrong answer to who is better. Make sure to comment down below your thoughts on who is the better goaltender. That'll do it for this one, and I'll see you guys next time.